Tunisia has been relatively calm in recent years, despite a series of attacks a few years before that.
Yeah, that's right. If we go back to 2015, there were a few very large-scale attacks targeting Western tourists at the Bardo National Museum, when 22 people were killed, mostly European tourists, and at that beach resort near Sousse, when a gunman fired on people there, killing 38, mainly British tourists. After that, a state of emergency was imposed by Tunisian authorities, and they started a crackdown, some would say perhaps heavy-handed in some areas. But since then, we've seen no big attacks of that scale, but smaller attacks seeming to target the security forces, so police, army officers, as we're appearing to see today in Tunis. And it's been kind of following the same pattern. Now, there haven't been regular attacks. The last one, really, we saw of this type was a year ago. But we've seen suicide bombers blowing themselves up outside police cars or police buses or military buses with soldiers on patrol. So there have been a spate of attacks in Tunisia, but it's important to put this in context. This is not the situation that we're seeing across the border in Libya or in other countries in the Middle East. Clearly, there are gaps in the security, but there has been a crackdown in this state of emergency imposed after 2015.